Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. To my panel, Dr. Syahbudin and Dr. Muhammad Ho, I'm Muhammad Arif bin Zu'azwar, and today I would like to present my final year project with the title Data-Driven Faulty Identification using IoT Device for Intelligent Machine Condition Monitoring, and I was supervised by Dr. Hadan Hafiz. This section is about background and motivation. Why IoT? This is because IoT, we can help the maintenance prediction which can process the large amount of data. The data will process machine learning with the integrated of SCADA, supervisory control and data acquisition, and display the data, helping the operator and other employee analyze the data and make important decisions. Besides that, IoT can stream real-time data because within a cloud as a storage base, and it can storing big data such as terabyte data with all the data we run in the machine learning with the process data can forecast potential hazard and malfunction equipment. There will be some question that will be in your mind, especially how to transform the reactive maintenance method in industry machining to IoT based predictive maintenance method. Second is how automatic identify and classify the industry machining health status in the context of smart machine monitoring system. Lastly, what is a practical and industry applicability of the smart machine monitoring system? So the research objectives are first to construct IoT platform for the smart machine monitoring system. Second is to analyze the data from IoT platform by using machine learning tool. Third is demonstrate the applicability of the teleport platform and the tool for practical and industrial cases. In this research, there are some limitations and scope involved which first is general sensor used with limited rate to stream lag. Second, its data can be collected in type of rotating machine. Lastly, type of machine faulty is limited such as unbalanced and misalignment. Next is a research methodology section. The research methodology were divided into three objectives. The first one is a data collection, second is data analysis, and lastly is a data validation. For data collection, the first step is mount the IoT device in the machine. In a Blink open source app, the data can live stream from the cloud to the smartphone. Besides that, Blink also capable to visualize live graph data and save data in form of CSV format. For the data analysis, for the data processing process, MATLAB is used for visualization and analysis of data, data cleaning and preparation before the development of prediction model is a crucial step. For example, data may have missing value or wrong value can be variation timestamp format. For process Fourier transformation, FFT, is a mathematical concept that can convert a continuous signal from time domain to frequency domain. Data validation, the data collected by IoT platform, ESP8266 microcontroller, is in the acceleration signal same goes to the rotating machine. The collected data will compare by the signal is captured with the frequency sampling equal to 20 Hz. Therefore, using FFT in MATLAB to equation between each frequency sampling from microcontroller ESP8266 and frequency from the rotating machine. Design of IoT device. The design of enclosure for the IoT device came from idea from a box. The enclosure was created with two different parts, the body and the top cover. The large surface area from the box can help to absorb more vibration. The dimension of the box is 148mm x 87mm after considering the sensor condition. This section is about preliminary data. The schematic diagram of IoT device is illustrate the device component using graphical symbol. Beside that is show how connection between microcontroller and sensor. measurement procedure. First is create coding for MCU using software Arduino IDE, then create diagram in Node-RED for storing file and data saving. Clamp the board into the machine, make sure the board does not move or rattle. Set up the machine with three different frequencies, which is 6, 8 and 10 Hz. Run and collect the data for 30 seconds because in the MCU coding, frequency is set to 20 Hz. Save it on CSV file, then rerun again by add mask to the rotating wheel for faulty condition. In this section, it's about result and discussion. There are two data collection. First is a normal condition. The normal operation acceleration signal is presented on the three axis measurement for X, Y, and Z. The signal is captured with frequency sampling equal to 20 Hz. The second data collection is faulty condition. The same operation, but the one added mask is installed on the rotating wheel to introduce unbalanced condition, and this condition regarded as a faulty operation. The signal is captured still same as a 20 Hz. Warning system for faulty operation detection is to prevent machine from entering a faulty operation. Thus, an early warning system is necessary to be set up for the critical assets such as a rotating machinery equipment. The warning system can be in form of real-time alert system or near real-time warning system to require post-processing of the collected data. Besides that, a threshold value was set up inside the Blink app to trigger the alert whenever the magnitude of the acceleration exceeds the provided value. A value of 8.65 Hz is observed from FFT result while the machine frequency was set to 8 Hz. The value of FFT will be minus with machine frequency, then divided by the value of FFT and times 100% to get the error. There is a variation between the result from ESP8266 microcontroller and the machine due to the noise. This section is about conclusion and recommendation. On this conclusion, the project achieved three main research objectives by successfully designed, tested, and deployed. Besides that, it successfully transmit in real-time manner and warning system. Lastly, able to demonstrate in detecting faulty condition of rotating machine. In this recommendation, first is use Node-RED as a warning system because it can store large data and using local server. Second, in future, Blink will be send data to local host or store data in their own server rather than public server. Lastly, the project can be improved by implementing artificial intelligence for automatic the whole process until detecting faulty. That's all for now. Thank you for listening. My presentation, final year project.